South African star cyclist Ryan Gibbons is back home following his exploits at the African Championships, where he was crowned champion. Gibbons is also part of Africa's World Tour cycling team, Qhubeka ASSOS. My colleague Tshepo Thobane is in Muldersdrift currently, where Gibbons is out for a ride. And he joins us now live. Titi, first of all, good morning to you. I hear the cycling started around 8 o'clock this morning. Nice, cool morning to go cycling, yes?
Hello, Nicole. Of course, yes, it's a lovely, beautiful morning here. We are actually at Riverstone Lodge in Muldersdrift, where obviously members of the Team South Africa, that is the cycling team, took part or are busy taking part in a ride earlier into the cradle of humankind. Well, to tell us more about that, we are privileged to be joined by the team manager of Team South Africa, that is the cycling team, that is Tony Hardin. Tony, good morning. I mean, a lovely morning here in Muldersdrift. I mean, take us through the event today. What was happening?
Well, it's always great to be here, and thank you for your guys' time being here. The event that's happened today, we've just come back from the Intercontinental Champs in Egypt, where South Africa competed in 16 events. And in the 16 events, we walked away with 13 gold medals. So that's a pretty special performance. And there's a number of those athletes that are out here today. Obviously, when you're selected for Team South Africa in cycling, it's pretty much like football out there or rugby. You represent Bafana Bafana, but you might come from Orlando Pirates, Kaizer Chiefs, Mamelodi Sundowns. It's the same with cycling. You know, they're not all from the same team. They're from different clubs, different teams around the world. But when they come together, South Africa, it's one unit. So we've got a couple of the guys out here. Ryan Gibbons, he's one of our top pros from the Team UAE Emirates overseas, a Tour de France rider. Then we've got the Team ProTouch boys, three of them represented South Africa now in Egypt. So we decided to actually make this available to a couple of the fans out there and guys who want to join them, just get to rub shoulders with guys that you don't normally get to go and do a ride with. And we decided that, you know, we use Riverstone Lodge for a lot of our events. We use it as a bit of a clubhouse. It's a great venue. So we've decided, let's get the guys together, give people out there, fans, an opportunity to ride with some of these superstars.
I mean, Tony, we are living in the times of COVID. How difficult has the sport been?
The sport is incredibly difficult living in COVID. You know, you can be ready to go to an event, and at the 11th hour, your bags are packed and suddenly, oh, it's cancelled. No, we can't do it. The venue or the event has actually been moved a couple of months further up the line. It's very difficult to train for that. You have to plan. You have to peak at the right time. So with these events being moved all the time, you can have your guys as close to 100% fitness as possible for an event, and then suddenly it gets changed. Now you've got all these supercharged engines waiting to rev, and there's nowhere for them to go and rev. So, yeah, it is very difficult. You know, in Egypt, we had to have a COVID test before we left here. We landed 2 days after that. We had COVID test, nose and throat, which are terrible. And then 72 hours before you land back in your country, you have to have COVID tests again. So I think I've had 9 or 10 COVID tests. Luckily, they've all been negative. But, yeah, I'm pretty much a COVID test specialist, and so are most of the cyclists.
Tony, tell us about the experience in Egypt. You touched on it earlier. I mean, for the team to, I mean, you represented us very well with obviously Ryan coming back with 4 gold medals. How was the competition, the competitiveness of the event in Egypt?
The competition in Africa has really got strong over the years. You know, if you look at guys like Eritrea, the Ethiopians, the Rwandans, the Moroccans, they've all got guys that are riding World Tour teams. They're powerhouses of Africa. South Africa is a powerhouse of Africa as well. We're getting back to where we are. ProTouch is the number one continental team in Africa, and a lot of the points we get from riding those events help South Africa maintain its ranking. So South Africa is also ranked the highest nation in Africa. There were 18 countries taking part. It wasn't only the elite and the under-23s of guys like Ryan Gibbons, Kent Main, Travis Steadman. It was also the junior boys, the junior girls, the ladies, and those are riders that I don't get to work with on a regular occasion. So the level of cycling in South Africa, as far as representing the national team, I think it is there. There's a lot of work that needs to be done, but it is positive, and I always try and find positives. The results speak for themselves. I think that as far as competing nation, it's positive. We're going in the right direction. There's always extra that can be done, though.
Thank you so much, Tony. That was Tony Hardings telling us about the Team South Africa going in the right direction. Well, Nicole, later we are going to be speaking to, of course, the champion, that is Ryan Gibbons, who's going to be telling us about his experiences in Egypt.
Thank you for that, TT, and definitely we are looking forward to catching up with you a bit later. That's it.